since the demise of the Sex Pistols, they're England's most powerful, most intense band. Recently, The Clash visited Toronto with Northern Ireland's Undertones. These two bands, the most politically active rock and roll groups, drove some hardcore fans to near frenzy. In the spirit of all devout rock and rollers, The Clash traveled with a whole entourage, who were all disappointed that North American punk fans behave in such a docile manner. This is the scene after the Clash concert.
It's fucking great. It proves that somewhere in North America there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9,
this is what
10,
does
11,
it.
12, 13, 14, there's at least 14, 15, 15 slash 16, that counts. 16 rock and roll fans in North America.
17, they started, we were starting.
17, well there you are, there's a couple over, there's probably 20 rock and roll fans in America.
I'm here on the whole tour.
Oh really, what are you doing on the tour?
Ligging.
Oh.
Friggin' and
ligging. Far out. You contribute to the flashing.
What? No, me, I was stomping on the side.
Oh, that's good, a team one.
Oh, you're the chick that ripped the
one. Oh yeah, well I ripped out that one, and then one I don't know.
Does this usually happen? Yeah, it used to be. I mean, we used to, seats up to there not missing, right?
Miles away, and then they ended up having to take the seats out because they couldn't make any money at their gigs.
How come you're up on stage here? Are you, what exactly are you doing with the tour?
Ligging.
Ligging, yeah. I don't know what that means.
Having a laugh.
Oh, ho, ho. So you're just along for the ride.
Yeah, you know what I mean? We think this is really funny. We think it's great. Because like, it shows how many loonies there are in Toronto.
But there's not enough.
But there's not enough. You know what I mean? Otherwise, the whole row would have been...
You'd be happy to see the whole place.
Yeah, at least up into that row there, like about five rows past where those blokes are sitting. Then it'd been all right.
Basically, what we're here for, right, is that it's like for us, we're like visiting, you know what I mean? And all these places we go to, we've been like 52 different countries. You could say, and the only thing they got in common with each other, this is America, which I'm talking about, and perhaps Canada as well, is they all listen to like mostly shit music, you know? And that's what we're doing, is we're here to alleviate that, you know? Get people dancing, help them remember what rock and roll used to be like, and is now, but only in a very few cases, right? And we're the best example of that.
What is it behind it that makes it more real than anybody else's music?
I'd say we try harder. That's all it is. It ain't nothing. Like, I don't just think we're not particularly talented. You know, you can talk about Sam Cooke. Right?
I'll tell you
that's talent, right? But we're not particularly talented. We dry on.
What is it in terms of the energy? I mean, you put out more energy.
We give it all we got. That's all. It's as simple as that. And like, everybody's used to paying $8 and getting half measures and like going home satisfied. Well, in England they gave up being satisfied 3 years ago, and it's spreading too. It's spreading to about 8 towns, cities in America. It's spreading, and in Canada it's spreading, and like people just ain't satisfied with that anymore, and you got to give it all you got or forget it.
What about the money behind the Clash? Is that that's the money that the Clash takes in. That's going to something different than what most rock and rollers use it for.
We use our money to prop up our faltering group. You know, we use our money to pay our road crew. We use our money to put gas in the tank of the coaches. And after that, we pass around it and we got about $5 left, you know. I wouldn't say that we had any money to use to anything positive, you know. I would like to see people who can fill 110,000 stadium bowls and get an intake of $750,000 per evening. I would like to see them use that money in some way, like maybe, for example, in Montreal, they had one club that was willing to play New Wave, and the government, the local government, stepped in and said, this is going to be a youth club. So, no music, you know. This is a youth club, number one rule, no music. What the hell is youth interested in? If it isn't music, you know, you tell me it ain't poetry or ping pong balls or making baskets out of raffia.
Mm-hmm. What do you think about the bootleg LPs of the Clash that are going around? I mean, that's taking money out of your pocket.
Well, I say good luck to it, because by now, in a group in our position, we should have hit you with a live LP of our old standards done live for $10 or whatever you like to pay, you know, and we haven't hit you with it because we're trying to do something new. We're trying to give you we're trying to show up the other groups by saying this is what a proper group does, not sells old rubbish that you've already bought on the first records, you know? And like, these bootleg people, they, good luck to them, you know? If they want to come in and do the show and tape it and try and put it out, good luck to them. It's a pirate business, and like, we're watching for you, and if we catch you, we smash the microphones, we smash the tape recorder, and we wrap the tape around your head. But good luck to you. You know, if you can get it onto vinyl, then I'm not going to start chasing you.
Is it a message behind what you write that makes it a little more special than anything else?
Well,
because it's written about the fact that you guys did not have a choice back in Britain. It was either the Dole or rock and roll. And people here, they, you know, they're middle class people. They have that choice. I mean, they really can't understand that.
Yeah, well, I'll say to the middle class, you know, I'll say, cobblers, you know, what choice have you got? Have you got your chance of a 79 Chevette hatchback or what? What is it, you know? You got your chance to sit there listening to a load of drivel or, you know, what is, that's your choice and it ain't no choice at all.
Well, rock then, rock. We're seeing hell.
Strummer! Get on! What about this thing that you're planning with the Undertones, an outdoor concert in Ireland on neutral ground? What's that all about?
Well, that was cancelled about 3 weeks ago. If you want to talk about Northern Ireland, you better get there. Come here, Undertones.
Let's get the Undertones in.
Give me an Undertones. Fergal Sharp. Fergal Sharp.
Yeah. And they're on their toes.
Come on, yeah,
Undertones. This man here. These are Undertones from Derry, if you want to talk about Northern Ireland.
Like I was saying to Joe, you were planning this outdoor benefit thing on neutral territory with yourself and the Clash, I mean, which seemed like a great idea, but I mean, what happened?
Couldn't get insurance for it.
That's what it was?
Mm-hmm. Insurance companies are really tough on the Clash,
you
know? Because
tough on us.
See, tough on us. Because my mother never paid her insurance for 40 years. And then when my father died, she tried to claim and they wouldn't give her any money for it. So they said, if we were ever doing anything, they wouldn't give us insurance for it. And we live with tanks and barricades and people with guns pointing at us, and we can't get a night's sleep. And
explosions.
I don't want to talk about it. It's too much for me. It's just too much. We're war babies. My mommy has to be with a big stick every night because I don't go to my bed in time. It's a bore, really. Derry would be a bore without the rats.
What about the new album, Joe? What's in it for that?
Well, a new record, you know, it's got some music on it, you know, and it's kind of, we just finished it before we came here, so maybe we'll get it out, I don't know. We ain't getting much help in getting records out around here, though.
What's the problem?
Well, we got a few problems. You know, we got a number one, record company don't know we're signed to them, which is like a major problem. Number two, radio stations don't seem to know we make music. You know, number three, the high school kids don't even know we exist. Number four, we feel a little depressed. And number five, maybe we'll go home soon, you know.
What about the movie that the Clash is supposedly working on?
It's in the garbage can.
What happened there?
Well, we had an argument with the people who was making it.
One other question, Joe, if I could. What are your views on the Buzzcocks?
The Buzzcocks? I think they're a bit limp.
Why, what's the matter with them?
Well, I don't know. It's a bit, I think they're getting sloppy in their old age.
They're not even very old. You did a tour with them. How were they then?
They were great.
And now you just think they're boring?
Well, you know, I just saw them the other day in Minneapolis, and I figured, like, it's a bit sloppy, the show, you know, you can't come over here and do that.
Leave the dressing room, we walk down the hall into the end, all right? Spencer Tracy grovelling in the muck, all right? Let's have it now, come on. Britain's number one DJ.
It's been ever so wonderful to be here in Toronto. What a lot of bull. I've never talked to him. Hey, come on, Mick. We're going. Why are you carrying an umbrella?
Pardon me, boy.
Is that a Chattanooga choo-choo? Woo!